Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about the nested and auxiliary routes. First, let's talk about nested routes. Nested routes in Angular help us split our application into smaller paths, making the routing easier to manage and understand. Nested routes are used to create separate routes for each module. We will be looking for exam module with the following routes. First is exam/datesheet and second is exam/result. Let's implement it in our application. First, I'm going to add my exam module, ng generate module exam, and if we want to add the routing, then --- routing, and I want to add its reference in the main module, which is our app module. Now in this module, I'm going to create two more components. First, we will move to its folder. Then ng generate component result. Next, I'm going to create another component, ng generate seat datesheet. And you can see that we have here exam module, and in this exam module we have two components, datesheet and result, and in it we have exam routing.module.ts file and its module 2. Now in this exam routing, I'm going to define its routes, and here first I'm going to define the path for the result component and then path for the datesheet component. These both are our nested routes. Now this modules route we need to define in our app routing file. For that we need to lazy load this exam route in our main route. And first I'm going to define the path. Then we will load child. And we will load it with the lambda expression. And then we will import its path. Dot then, and here we give it module's name, which is exam module. Now we will move to our app.component.html file, where we have defined all our routes. Currently we have one route here, and I'm going to add two more. And how we can access these routes here? First, I'm going to write its module path, and then going to define its component path. Now let's run the application to test these all the components. And as you can see, here we have three components loaded: view, student, result, and datesheet. Here we use two nested routes, result and datesheet, and one is main route, which is view, student route. Next we have auxiliary routes. Auxiliary routes allow for multiple independent routes to be displayed in different outlets simultaneously. Now what auxiliary routes do? It allows us to set up and navigate multiple independent routes in a single app. For example, if I want to load both view student and result component at the same time, then I will use auxiliary route. First, I'm going to create our auxiliary route. And I'm going to name this auxiliary route is exams. Next, I'm going to change this route in our app routing module. Now after lazy loading, I'm going to define its router outlet, and our outlet is exams. And here we define that our exam module will be loaded in our outlet. And then last, we need to modify these both the router links, result and datesheet. And I'm going to define this router link as the Angular attribute. And in this first we have square brackets and then curly brackets, and inside this we will write our router outlets. In this outlets I will write the name of our outlet, which is exams, and then we will define our module route, and next is our nested route result. Exactly like this, we will define our router outlet for the datesheet. Now in this case, view student is displayed, but if we click on the result, it's not hiding the view student component, but it's showing the multiple components. One is our view student, which was a regular route, and the second is auxiliary route. Our route is also showing that we are opening this result and datasheet routes in auxiliary routes. So auxiliary routes are independent secondary routes that can be added to a page along with the primary route. Now if we see the benefits of nested routes, then these are used for the code organization, view hierarchies, for reusability and modularization, and for the sake of lazy loading and performance. So this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand the nested and auxiliary routes. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.